estou sozinho, apaixonado.
Mendoza focuses on social commentary within his films. For example, the protagonist Clara in Aquarius symbolizes resistance against real estate development, which is a microcosm of broader concerns about urban gentrification in Brazil.
Todo mundo saiu de lá menos a senhora. Se a senhora pensar direitinho, a senhora está sendo egoísta.
Clara's refusal to sell her apartment to a powerful construction company becomes a metaphor for the resistance of individuals against the erasure of cultural and historical identity in the face of urban development. Clara's connection to her home represents the attachment to cultural heritage, which is often threatened by rapid urbanization. The real estate conflict serves as a commentary on the clash between tradition and modernization, echoing broader societal tensions in Brazil. Mendoza Filho's films often portray the struggles of different social classes. By highlighting the challenges faced by characters like Clara and Aquarius, he sheds light on the broader class disparities and the impact of economic forces on individuals' lives. The director's focus on urban settings and the consequences of urban development contributes to discussions on the impact of modernization on cities. The emphasis on preserving cultural identity as seen in Aquarius reflects Mendoza Filho's concerns with the erosion of cultural values amid rapid societal changes. This resonates with broader discussions on the preservation of cultural heritage in the face of modernization. Filho's social commentary sparks conversations on the role of filmmakers in addressing societal issues. His nuanced approach encourages viewers to critically examine the interconnectedness of class struggle, urbanization, and cultural identity in the context of Brazil's evolving landscape.
And I think Aquarius is very much a siege movie. Of Clara is in this perfectly nice place, which is where she lives, and there are people trying to come in and trying to disrupt her life and the way she lives, and her apartment is very clearly defined by walls and windows and doors, and of course there are the outside elements, you know, the construction company and the workers, and we never really know what they're up to, and I thought that that would generate enough tension to keep the film going, and hopefully that's what it is. It's an interesting, mysterious, and entertaining siege movie.
Mendoza Filho also has a unique visual style, using cinematography, camera angles, and framing to show a story within his films. Mendoza Filho often employs lower angles to empower characters or high angles to create vulnerability. This dynamic use of camera angles enhances the emotional impact of scenes. His framing choices are deliberate, capturing characters within specific environments to emphasize their relationship or isolation. Tight close-ups convey emotional nuances. There are also visual motifs, one of which includes windows in Aquarius. Windows symbolize both transparency and barriers. Clara's interactions with the world outside her window reflect her defiance against external pressures while highlighting the theme of introspection. Mendoza Filho's films are often rooted in specific regions of Brazil. The choice of locations contributes to the authenticity of the narratives, showcasing the diverse cultural and geographical aspects of the country. The director pays attention to the architectural details of settings, utilizing them to convey historical, cultural, and social contexts. Filho's visual style, characterized by meticulous cinematography and thoughtful setting choices, establishes a distinctive atmospheric tone. This tone often evolves with the narrative, enhancing the viewer's engagement. Mendoza Filho's visual style invites discussions on the role of aesthetics in storytelling. The deliberate use of camera angles and settings becomes a language through which he communicates nuanced themes. By analyzing Mendoza Filho's visual style, we gain insight into how cinematography and setting serve as a powerful tool for storytelling and thematic exploration in his films. Mendoza Filho also has unique narrative techniques. Mendoza Filho strategically employs flashbacks to unveil crucial elements of characters' pasts. These flashbacks serve as a narrative purpose, providing context, motivation, or emotional depth to the character's present circumstances. He also uses memory as a theme. Memory becomes a thematic thread in Filho's storytelling. Characters grapple with memories, and the selective use of flashbacks becomes a tool for exploring the impact of the past on the present.
The film itself is very much about the past, the present, and the future. And there are many little elements throughout the film which work as a kind of some kind of time device, a time machine device, which takes us backwards and forwards into the past and into the present, but all in little details and little objects and photographs and memory and discussion about somebody whose name you can't really.
Mendoza Filho integrates allegorical elements into his storytelling. Symbolic representations and metaphors add layers of meaning, allowing audiences to engage with the film on a symbolic level beyond the surface narrative. Symbolism becomes a conduit for social commentary. Objects, settings, and characters carry symbolic weight, enabling Filho to explore societal issues in a nuanced manner. It is very clear that Mendoza Filho has had an impact on Brazilian cinema. He has been a trailblazer in introducing a new cinematic language to Brazilian cinema. His innovative storytelling, unique visuals, and thematic depth have inspired a generation of filmmakers to explore unconventional narratives. His films gaining international acclaim has elevated the visibility of Brazilian cinema on the global stage. This recognition has encouraged other Brazilian filmmakers to experiment with diverse storytelling methods. Mendoza Filho's films serve as a platform for social critique, delving into issues such as urbanization, class struggle, and societal challenges in Brazil. This representation goes beyond surface narratives, offering nuanced portrayals of the complexities within Brazilian society. Mendoza Filho's commitment to cultural authenticity is evident in the meticulous representation of Brazilian settings, characters, and traditions. His films become a mirror reflecting the multifaceted nature of Brazilian culture, challenging stereotypes, and presenting a more authentic narrative. This commitment to inclusivity contributes to a more comprehensive and diverse representation of Brazilian identities. His films challenge preconceived notions about Brazil, presenting a more intricate and layered depiction. This nuanced representation has a profound impact on how Brazil is perceived both domestically and internationally, breaking away from simplistic stereotypes. Mendoza Filho's ability to craft narrative that resonate globally has opened doors for emerging Brazilian filmmakers to explore diverse themes. It presents an opportunity for the industry to move beyond traditional expectations and engage with a broader international audience. Filmmakers might feel pressured to conform to establish perceptions of Brazilian cinema, hindering experimentation and exploration of unique narratives. Balancing global accessibility with preserving cultural nuances becomes a delicate challenge as filmmakers navigate the fine line between commercial viability and cultural integrity. Mendoza Filho's role in shaping Brazilian cinema extends beyond individual films. It encompasses a transformative influence on storytelling practices, representation, and the global recognition of Brazilian cinema. His commitment to authenticity and exploration of diverse narrative encourages a more dynamic and inclusive cinematic landscape. Mendoza Filho also has recurring motifs, some of which being architecture and spaces. Architecture, especially urban spaces and buildings, is a recurring motif. These spaces often represent the physical and metaphorical landscapes of Brazil. They can symbolize the layers of history, socioeconomic disparities, and the evolving nature of Brazilian society. For example, in Neighboring Sounds, the focus on buildings and neighborhoods reflects the changing urban dynamics. Aquarius uses a specific apartment building as a symbol of resistance against gentrification. Water also appears as a symbolic element representing life, continuity, and memory. It is often used to evoke a sense of nostalgia or to underline the enduring aspects of Brazilian culture. The use of water is notable in Aquarius, where the protagonist's connection to her apartment and its seaside location becomes a powerful symbol of resistance and continuity. Mendoza Filho also constantly addresses social issues, particularly class struggle and inequality. This theme runs through various narratives, highlighting the disparities and tensions within Brazilian societies. For example, Neighboring Sounds explores the dynamics between a wealthy family and their neighbors, reflecting broader socioeconomic tensions. Bacurau delves into the clash between the marginalized residents of a small village and external forces. Resistance against external threats, whether from gentrification, political forces, or societal change, is also a common theme. Characters often embody a spirit of defiance against oppressive forces. The protagonist in Aquarius resists selling her apartment to a real estate developer, and in Bacurau, the villagers resist external attempts to erase their community. As we navigate the complexities of Mendoza Fiojo's cinematic realm, we are prompted to question, to reflect, and to engage critically with the multifaceted issues presented. His films challenge preconceived notions, inviting audiences to explore the interconnectedness of class struggle, urbanization, and cultural identity in the evolving context of Brazil. In the hands of Mendoza Fiojo, cinema becomes a transformative tool, a conduit for societal reflection and cultural preservation. In conclusion, Mendoza Fiojo stands as a luminary in contemporary Brazilian cinema, weaving narratives that transcend mere storytelling. Through meticulous societal commentary, nuanced visual storytelling, and a commitment to authentic representation, Mendoza Fiojo has not only shaped the landscape of Brazilian cinema, but has also left a mark on the global stage.
As marcas do meu tempo, meu desespero, a vida num